got a lot of serious problems in America today. A lot of very, very bad problems. Bad leadership in America. Yes, very, very bad leadership from the top. And even down into Nashville. We have politicians in Nashville that say it's okay for the one man to sodomize another man. Is that love? Is that love for a leader of our community to say it's okay to be gay? For men and women to advocate their God-given abilities to procreate, to have children, to create loving families? But we have politicians like Jim Cooper. Jim Cooper will say, hey, if you men want to spread AIDS amongst one another, you don't have a problem with that. Yeah, he says that, hey, if you want to go ahead and sodomize each other, if you want to spread AIDS among your community, Jim Cooper supports spreading AIDS. Jim Cooper supports sexual perversion. Now, I don't know if he promotes pedophilia, but if this pedophilia comes around in the LGBT community, will Representative Jim Cooper get on TV and debunk and chastise people for pedophilia? Maybe not. Maybe not. See, we need leadership that is righteous. We need leadership that loves God and obeys His commandments. See, in America, we got too many people, they don't even obey the commandments of men. You know, the laws of men are there to protect one another. Like, don't get drunk and drive. Don't drink and drive. Don't do drugs. Don't murder your children. Well, except if they're in the room. Now, Representative Jim Cooper, the last I heard, he says it's okay to kill your children if they're still in the room. That's not a loving representative. What is he representing anyway? He's representing death. Representative Jim Cooper is representing death through AIDS and the murder of children through abortion. The representative you need, the advocate you really need, is Jesus Christ. Because the advocacy of man will just lead you into perversion. If you follow Donald Trump doesn't have a problem with people sodomizing one another. If you follow man, you're going to follow wickedness. You need to follow Jesus Christ. And there's only one way to follow Jesus Christ, and that is to repent towards God for being a wicked, terrible person, which I hope Representative Jim Cooper does someday, because I don't want him to go to hell. I don't want any of my neighbors to go to hell. But it's the haters in our society that say it's okay to be gay, it's okay to say you love God, sodomize one another, and die and go to hell. That is hate speech. We're here to preach against hate speech. We're here to preach the love of Jesus Christ. See, if you were to appropriate the love of Jesus Christ, then you'd be able to turn from your deviancy. You'd be able to turn from your sin. You'd be able to be born again. And you could live a holy and righteous life in the sight of God. And you could love your neighbor. See, when you have sex with your neighbor, someone you're not married to, man with a woman with her husband, when you have sex with all kind of strangers, guess what? You get abuse, you get heartbreak, you get disease, and you get death. See, and you get hate. People throw cans at you. Look at the haters. I told you, we came out here to spread love, but people like this, they're going to throw cans at you. Why? Because they are hateful people. Yes, the sodomite celebration of today is out here spreading hate, but we're out here with a bullhorn on a street corner telling you about the love of God, spreading the love of the Lord. If you will accept it, we'll reject the love of God. Anybody, if you love God, you'd use your body in the way it was designed to be used. But since many in the sodomite supporting community, they don't use their body for how it's supposed to be used, they use it in perverted ways. They don't use their reproductive system for reproducing children. No! They intermingle it with the digestive system. See, if a man intermingles his reproductive organs with another man's sewage pipe, guess what? It's not healthy. It's not healthy for a man to have sex with another man's sewage pipe. Why would you think that that's okay? I'll tell you why. Because the devil convinced you that if it feels good, do it. That's what the devil has done. I even saw some of the devil's minions out here. They had a sign that says, Satan loves your pride. And we know that. Satan loves your pride, and God hates your pride. God loves humility. God loves a humble heart. And I'm not talking about the false God that you created in your own mind. I'm not talking about the false God that is preached at the Methodist church here in Nashville or any of the other sodomy-supporting church buildings in Nashville. I'm talking about the real God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The Christian God of the Bible says it's not okay to be gay. Now, if you mean gay, well, let's get right down to it. If you mean happy, happy's supposed to mean gay, right? If you're gay, it's supposed to mean you're happy. But most people today, when they talk about gay, what do they mean? Do they mean happy? They mean sexual deviant, sexual pervert. And they say it's okay to be gay, spread your disease, and die and go to hell. We're saying it's not okay. You know why? Because God says it's not okay. You need to be redeemed. The Bible says you need to be born again. The Bible says you could be made a new creature in Christ. You don't have to live as a pervert anymore. You could be normal. You could be a man living as a husband and a father. You could be a woman living as a wife and a mother. However, if you just want to be a sexual weirdo and die and go to hell, well, that's your prerogative. You can do that if you want. If you want to ignore God, hate God, then you're going to be judged by God, and God is going to set you in fire for all of eternity. We don't want that for our neighbors. We love our neighbors. That's why we don't tell you lies like it's okay to be a pervert. We're out here to tell you it's okay to repent towards God and put your faith in Jesus Christ. We're telling you about the fact that God commands all men everywhere to repent. That's what God says. That is the truth. We're out here to spread truth. Your sexual promiscuity is a lie. You think you're going to have a good time because you have sex with 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12 people tonight? That's not going to satisfy, because you know what's going to happen. Next weekend, you're going to want to have sex with 3, 4, 5, 10, 12, 15, 18 people. Because sin does not satisfy. Your sexual perversion does not satisfy. That's why some sexual deviants, homosexual men, they start having sex with other men that are younger and younger and younger, and then they end up being like a Harvey Milk having sex with teenagers and children. Because your sexual perversion doesn't satisfy. That's why you get more and more perverted. That's why there's bestiality coming into the gay pride community, because having sex with another man doesn't satisfy. Having sex with another woman doesn't satisfy. That's why you're having sex with another and another and another and another and another and another and another until you die and go to hell. We don't want you to die and go to hell. You're supposed to be in a relationship, one man, one woman. And you know what happens if a virgin man gets married to a woman that is also a virgin? You know what will never ever happen? No disease! No disease when you do it God's way. But unfortunately, a lot of people don't do it God's way, do they? No. Especially in the quote-unquote gay community, because they're not happy at all. They are the most angry, intolerant, and suicidal part of our society. But if you're a man and a woman who have never had sex with strangers, they would never have diseases, sexually transmitted diseases. But instead, what do you got? AIDS, herpes, chlamydia, human papilloma virus, gonorrhea, syphilis, crabs, genital herpes. That's what you get for doing things the way you want to instead of the way God commands you to do, the way God designed you. See, when you violate God's design, you die. Did you know that? If you violate God's design long enough, you gon' die. That's what the Bible says. Your sin leads unto death. 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 That's why there's so much suicide and murder in the sodomite community. Because it's not a lifestyle. That is another lie. It's not gay. It's misery. And it's not a lifestyle. It is a style of living that leads unto death. It is a death style in your sin. Not unlike the drunkard. If you want to guzzle your alcohol, you're going to die early. If you want to smoke your drugs, you're going to die early. If you want to inject your opiates into your veins, guess what? You're going to die early. The Bible says that your sin, your homosexuality, your sexual deviancy, your perversion leads to death. We're out here to preach life. We're out here to preach life unto our neighbors. We want you to live. We want our neighbors to live. We don't want you to die in your disease. We don't want you to die in your misery. We want you to live starting today. Truth be told, you could start life today. Life in Jesus Christ. If you were to repent towards God with a broken heart and a contrite spirit, with a humble heart, and if you were to put your faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, you could be saved. God would be faithful and justified in saving your soul from the hellfire you've earned for all your wickedness. God could save you if you were to humble yourself. But if you go on in your pride, you are making yourself God's enemy. You are making yourself God's enemy for your pride. You need to be humble. We're out here to preach life. We're out here to preach love and acceptance. Love and acceptance. You need to love God and stop hating God. You need to love God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength like Jesus commanded. That is the love you need to be concerned about. You need to be concerned about loving God. You need to be concerned about loving God and quit putting your hands on strangers. Today is the day you need to be born again and love God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And then you need to love your neighbor as yourself. Now let me define loving your neighbor. See, loving your neighbor doesn't mean having sex with all of your neighbors. That's not love. Loving your neighbor is not sodomizing another man. That is, in fact, a hate crime. A hate crime against your neighbor and a hate crime against God. And if you don't understand that, you'll find out after a while when you have to wear diapers because you can no longer control your lower digestive tract. Your lower digestive tract will be greatly damaged through your hate crime toward one another. But we want you to be loving people. We're out here to preach love and acceptance. Yes, you could be accepted by God on Judgment Day through faith in Jesus Christ, his death, burial, and resurrection, and repentance towards God with a broken heart and a contrite spirit. You could be born again, and when you die, you wouldn't die in your sin. You would die in Christ. And if you died in Christ, you would be accepted. You would be accepted into heaven if you were born again and appeared before a holy and righteous God, before the throne of heaven in the righteousness of his dear Son. You could be accepted into heaven. But unfortunately, the devil preaches a different acceptance, doesn't he? Yes, the devil has a different acceptance. The devil wants you to accept hate. He wants you to accept hate. Yes, if you just pleasure your genitals with strangers day after day after day, you are expressing hatred towards your neighbors, hatred toward God. No, we need more love in Nashville. Real love. Real love that does what is good for your neighbor. Benevolent love. That you go out of your way and try and do your neighbor some good. Like maybe go out on a street corner with a bullhorn and tell them how to be saved. That could be some good love. But if you go out and tell your neighbor, well, it's okay to sin. God says it's okay for you to be a pervert. if you say to people, oh, God says it's okay for you to, take hormones and have body parts chopped off, but that's not love at all. That's the devil's so-called love, and that's not loving. You need to be born,
excuse me.
See, we've come out here to love the Lord our God with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. But unfortunately, these people, these organizations in Nashville, they just want your money, and they just want you to sin. Like West End United Methodist Church of the Devil! West End United Methodist Church is on the cover of the room, sir. Can I have a little space?
I'm sorry.
Can I have a little space, sir? I'm not a sodomite. I don't want to be that close to your rear end. Thank you. A little space here. A little space. Don't touch me, sir. Yes, there's a lot of synagogues of Satan around Nashville today, like West End United Methodist Church.
They
watch their congregants to sodomize each other, spread AIDS among one another, and die and go to hell. You know why they want that? Because they are of their father, the devil. That's what the devil wants you to do at United Methodist Church, West End of Nashville. They don't love your soul, they hate your soul. So what do they love? They love your money. They love their easy job. That's what they love at West End United Methodist Church. They love your money. That's why they want you to show up every week. They love your sin. You can tell that because they promote the dictates of the devil. So you need to flee from the evil of the world, the synagogues of the devil. They are church building. See, a lot of people, they call themselves Christians. Now, a Christian should be doing what the Bible commands them to do. If you were actually a Christian, you would look into the holy words of God, and you would make that your business. But most people, they call themselves Christians today, they really don't read the Bible. They don't care what the Bible says. They just do what their traditions tell them. See, we have too many Pharisees in Nashville. We got too many Pharisaical organizations like West End United Methodist Church that has their tradition. They love their tradition, and they make the Word of God of none effect. That's the problem. People have their man-made traditions that have nothing to do with the Word of God, and they make the Word of God of none effect. Even though they give it lip service, they say, oh, we love God. They say, oh, we love Jesus. They say, oh, we read the Bible. And then they go out and sin, sin, sin. You know why? Because they're slaves. Slavery. That's what's going on. The Bible says if you live in your sin, you are a slave to your sin. If you are a homosexual or lesbian today, you are a slave to your perversion. If you're a drunkard today, you are a slave to your alcohol. If you are a drug abuser today, you are a slave to your chemicals. We're out here to preach freedom, freedom, freedom in Jesus Christ. Freedom where you don't have to live as a pervert or a drunkard or a drug abuser or a hater. You don't have to be a hateful, selfish person anymore. You can be someone that's loving and benevolent towards your neighbor. That's what you need to be. See, Jesus said to love the Lord your God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. But see the hate? See that man just has no finger. See the hate? I told you there's hateful people out here. We're out here to spread the love. We want to do what's good for our neighbor. We're not out here to use you. We're not out here to lead you into some satanic organization like the Roman Catholic cult or into Satanism or into lesbianism. No, we're out here to love our neighbor and to love God. That's our message today. No, ma'am, I don't hug strangers. I love my wife. I give my hugs for my wife. We're out here to give our neighbors love. Well, I hope Jesus loves you by the time you die. The only way you can have the love of Jesus is through faith and repentance. Otherwise, you have the wrath of God abiding over you because of your sin. So if you're a lesbian today, the wrath of God is abiding over you. If you're a sodomite today, the wrath of God is abiding over you. If you're a drunkard today, the wrath of God is abiding over you today. If you support sin, if you are a self-righteous hypocrite, you say, oh, I'm straight, I don't do drugs, oh, I don't lie, I don't steal, you're calling the Christian God of the Bible a liar. Because the Bible says that all men have sinned against God. You need to be humble before God. Self-righteous people, they don't go to heaven. Self-righteous people, they reject Jesus Christ. They're not saved. Then there's only one way to be saved. Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. That's what Jesus Christ said. But if you don't have the Jesus Christ of the Bible, the real Jesus, the one that was dead for 3 days and rose again and is seated on the right hand of the Father, he's the one you need. Now a lot of people have fake, phony, and fraudulent idols. And they call them Jesus, don't they? Like the Roman Catholics. The Roman Catholics, they got a dead Jesus. The Pope carries around a dead Jesus on a stick. Guess what? That Jesus can't do you any good. That Jesus can't save you. That Jesus is just an idol. The Mormons have a false Jesus. The Jehovah's Witnesses, they have a created Jesus. It was just maybe an angel or the brother of Lucifer. No. We have some help over here from the police. We've had our equipment vandalized. We're not allowed vandalism today, are we? We're not allowing vandalism out here today, are we? See, that's the hate and intolerance in the sodomite community. See, that's why we're out here. There are so many intolerant, hateful bigots. There are so many haters out here today. They'll come and vandalize your stuff. They'll try and put their arms around you. And they don't know what love is at all. See, there's some men out here, they think that love is sodomizing another man. Or in some other way, satisfying their lust in another man's digestive tract. That's not love. That's not love at all. You need to be loving towards God and loving towards your neighbor. Praise God that he doesn't throw anybody into hell, at least not anybody out here. He hasn't thrown you into hell yet, he has said. Praise God, he is merciful and he has been long-suffering towards you so far. But God is not always going to chide against you. God is not always going to let you go on in your sin. 10 out of 10 people die. Everybody out here, in the sound of my voice, you're going to die before too long. And then after you die, you're going to stand before God. The question is, are you going to stand before God in your sin and in your pride and in your self-righteousness? Because the Bible says if you try and do that, you're going to be naked and ashamed. If you die in your sin, you're going to be naked and ashamed before God. You're going to be clothed in your sin and your perversity and your iniquity. What you need to do is die in Christ. And there's only one way to die in Jesus Christ, and that is through repentance towards God. You need to be of a broken heart and a contrite spirit. Repent towards God for being wicked, wicked, wicked. And you need to put your faith in Jesus Christ. Yes, faith and repentance. You could be born again. You could be saved. You could be made a new creature in Christ. Then when you die, it's a different story. If you die in Christ, then you can be born again. Put your faith in Jesus Christ. See, this man isn't going to give up. This man's not going to come through the grave. This man is going to put your hands close up, you hateful man.
God loves you. God is peace.
There's always a big Jesus around, a false Jesus that is going to try and deceive people. See, this man right here, who is is mocking the Lord Jesus Christ, well, he's going to be judged one day. He's not going to conquer the grave. For all his mocking, for all his blasphemy, he's going to stand also naked and ashamed before God, and he's going to be cast into hellfire if he doesn't humble his heart and if he doesn't get born again through faith and repentance. That is our love message today. Love and acceptance. If you love God, you will obey God. If you love God and obey God, you'll be born again into the family of God. If you die while you're in the family of God, you will be accepted into the kingdom of God. You will stand in the congregation of the righteous. Hallelujah! There's going to be a congregation of the righteous in heaven. Now, it's not going to be like anything like the congregation of the wicked that we have out here today. The masses of people in the Nashville is a congregation of the wicked. So the congregation of the wicked, if you choose to remain in your wickedness and reject so great a salvation of Jesus Christ, you're going to be a congregation that's going to be cast into hellfire. We don't want you to be cast into hellfire. We want you to be saved. We want you to repent towards God and put your faith in Jesus Christ and be born again, so you can be accepted into the family of God, born again, and adopted into the kingdom of God.